A couple weeks back, Swiffy22 lapped out a new movement technique in Breath of the Wild, the stasis bounce. By shield jumping in front of a stasis object on a very specific timing, you can essentially get bullet time bounce level speeds without losing any stamina during the setup. These bounces are slowly finding their way into speedrunning, but are still considered fairly inconsistent. So in this tutorial, I want to break down the basics of how to perform a stasis bounce in two steps. However, I am fully aware that this trick is still being researched more and small details of it are coming out. So if there is ever new important developments about it, check the comments and there will be a pinned comment about it. Most commonly used for stasis bounces are these metal crates. I'm going to be using these here at the Magnesis Shrine on the Great Plateau. In order to set up the bounce, we can use Magnesis to put one of the flat sides of the crate into the direction we want to bounce in. Let's say we want to bounce towards Hyrule Castle in this example. So I'm going to align the metal crate like this. A stasis bounce does not give you much height, so getting up to this wall here will be mandatory. Once the crate is set up, we want to place Link on the opposite side of the side that's aligned in our bounce direction. Then we use stasis on it and charge the crate up with a back-facing spin attack until the arrow is red and pointing to where we want to go. Once that is done, we want to quickly cancel the spin attack and walk back to the side that's facing our destination. Walking up against that side of the crate will align Link by him trying to push the crate. I have more success with this if I do this on the left or right side. As he's doing that, press and hold ZL, so Link takes out his shield and stays static so you can focus on step 2, the timing. Once we are set up, we need to get ready to time our shield jump, so before we even do that, we need to understand the timing. When an object is stasis'd, it is going to start making these sounds that are getting faster and faster. This happens in 3 steps. This is step 1. This is step 2. And this is step 3. For a stasis bounce, we want to listen to these sounds. Our audio cue is the 5th sound of the 3rd step, so the fastest sounds. Here again, this is our audio cue specifically. On this 5th sound, we want to start our shield jump, so make sure to count in your head as you are listening. Since the timing is not exactly on the 5th sound, make sure to perform the jump on reaction, not anticipation. You want to jump as soon as you hear the 5th sound. This has given me the best results. So once you are done with the setup and you are listening to the sounds, when you hear the 5th sound, press the jump button while holding out your shield. And then, when you come down from the first shield jump, time the jump button again, so Link shield jumps again on contact with the ground. If everything worked out, you should be bouncing through Hyrule. Make sure to deactivate the Rook's protection, if you have it, to avoid fails. Fails are really common here, the timing is extremely precise. This double shield jump in general can already be hard to get down on its own, so make sure to practice it without any crates to increase your chances of getting a successful stasis bounce. Now, it's time for you to get creative and try out different bounces. There's even one used in the Any% category now without even using the glider. And on that note, I'm very close to beating the game in less than 30 minutes and I'm currently grinding for it on my Twitch channel, which is linked in the description. If you want to see that live and also watch some stasis bounces, make sure to follow there and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more advanced Breath of the Wild content. Thank you guys for watching and see you in the next one. We'll be right back.